Welcome back, students. Today we will be learning about leveling in this video lecture. Leveling is a branch of surveying and the object of which is to find the elevation of given points with respect to a given datum. Okay, and also to establish the point at a given elevation or at different elevations with respect to given or assumed datum. Now, datum is any surface to which elevations are referred. So, it is like a reference point from which we are from that particular point we will be calculating all the different elevations, and we will be getting or we can establish a point on the ground with respect to that particular datum. So, as I have already mentioned, mean sea level, that is MSL, is a convenient datum worldwide, and the elevations are commonly given as above the MSL or below the mean sea level. Okay, leveling deals with measurements in a vertical plane. So, we will be talking only about the vertical surveying or vertical distances or vertical observations in this particular branch of surveying. Now, what do you mean by elevation? It is a vertical distance above or below as an from an assumed datum. So now, if we are doing or carrying out a surveying work in our college campus, or for that matter any on any of the plot, it is difficult for us to consider mean sea level as the datum. So what happens is, what we can do is, we can fix a kind of a permanent point in that particular area. So, for example, we can consider already constructed a step, or if there is a slab that is put up, the point which is not going to alter for quite a long time. So, it is called as a benchmark. It is relatively permanent point of reference whose elevation is known with respect to some assumed data. So, the elevation of that particular point that you have marked within the area of survey is already known with respect to mean sea level. So, after that, the survey that we are going to carry out within that area, we will be considering the benchmark as our reference point or benchmark as our data. We are not going to consider every time mean sea level. We know the elevation of the benchmark with respect to mean sea level. Okay, so this is done only for convenience. When we will do the actual practical, you will understand why this benchmark is taken. Now, there are different methods of leveling. First is the barometric leveling, second is trigonometric leveling, and third one is spirit leveling. A barometric leveling makes use of a phenomenon that difference in elevation between two points is proportional to the difference in atmospheric pressure at these points. A barometer may be used, and the reading observed at different points would measure the relative elevations of those particular points. Second, trigonometric leveling. From the name itself, you can understand that we are going to use or we are going to calculate or compute the vertical angles and horizontal the elevations using the vertical angles and the horizontal distances. So, we can use a Pythagoras theorem, or we have the sine theta cos theta equations which can give us the vertical distances or horizontal distances using trigonometry. The last one is spirit leveling. So, this is the method of direct leveling. It is a branch of leveling in which the vertical distances with respect to horizontal line may be used to determine the relative difference in elevation between two adjacent points. The horizontal plane of sight, or the horizontal line of sight you can consider, is to level the surface at any point is readily established by means of a spirit level. Now, a spirit level and a sighting device, a sighting device is a telescope, are combined, and vertical distances are measured by observing on graduated rods placed on the points. If you see the diagram, you will understand what this spirit level and a sighting device is. Okay, so we are going to learn spirit leveling in detail. So the spirit level is used to level the instrument, that is the spirit bubble, and the sighting device, that is the telescope, that is mounted onto this, or both are combined together so that we get a straight or horizontal line of sight to calculate the level. Okay, so leveling instrument, so this is a level. Level is the instrument that is used to find out the elevation of any point. The purpose of the level is to provide horizontal line of sight. So it is going to give us a horizontal line of sight. It consists of following four parts. First is the telescope. Second is the level tube. Third is leveling head. And fourth is the tripod. The telescope is provided to give the line of sight. So this is the telescope. This is the telescope from where we are going to sight the object. Okay, so we are going to sight the object using the telescope. Second is the level tube. This particular part is the level tube, which makes the line of sight horizontal. This particular instrument should be exactly horizontal. So this is the line of sight within the telescope. This has to be perfectly horizontal line of sight so that we get the perfect elevation of any point. So this level tube here, which is mounted, is used to level the instrument to get the perfect horizontal line of sight. The leveling head is to bring the bubble in its center of the run. So the entire tripod also has to be leveled. Now this particular instrument is mounted on a tripod, and this tripod has to be perfectly leveled. So the leveling head is used to level the tripod here. Okay. And the last one is the tripod on which the instrument is mounted. It supports the instrument. There are different types of levels that are used. Okay, there is something called as dumpy level, there is something called as Y level, reversible level, and tilting level, out of which we are going to use a dumpy level. This is how it looks. So we will be using a dumpy level to carry out different experiments here. A Y level is this. Okay, it looks something like this. This is the reversible level, sorry, tilting level. I do not have a photograph of reversible level. You can always refer it online. Now I will give you the details of dumpy level as we are going to use this, but I want you all to study what is Y level, reversible level, and tilting level. It is there in surveying one textbook, BC Punya, on page number, it starts from 197. So you can read and note down the details or make your own notes. Okay. So we will be studying dumpy level in detail. Now, dumpy level consists of a telescope tube firmly secured in two corners, fixed by adjusting screws to a stage carried by the vertical spindle. The advantages of dumpy level are it is the simpler construction with fewer movable parts, fewer adjustments to be made, and longer life of adjustments. Okay, this is how it looks. This is the cross section of a dumpy level. So this is the telescope. Okay. This is the eyepiece from where we are supposed to sight the object. This is the object glass from which it will be visible. This is the longitudinal bubble which you are supposed to adjust. Okay, this is the focusing screw. This is the diaphragm. This is focusing screw is to focus the object. These are the foot screws which are attached to the tripod stand. So we are supposed to use these foot screws to level the instruments. Okay, so the connection of the instrument to the tripod is made, then it is leveled, and then we carry out the experiment. Okay, here it is clearly seen in this particular picture. So this is the telescope. These are the three foot screws which are mounted on the, which are used to level the instruments, and it is connected here to the tripod. Okay. Second leveling instrument is the leveling staff. It is a straight rectangular rod having graduations. The foot of the staff representing the zero reading, and the purpose of the staff is to determine the amount by which the station is the foot of the staff is above or below the line of sight. So there are two types. One is self-reading stuff and second one is the target stuff. Self-reading stuff is can be read directly from the instrument, and target stuff, there has to be a stuff meant to read the stuff. We are going to use a self-reading stuff for experiment. Okay, staff is basically the vertical scale, you can say. It's a vertical scale wherein all the graduations are marked, and we will have to read the scale and find out the elevation. Adjustments of level. There are two types of adjustments for the instrument. One is permanent adjustment, second one is temporary adjustments. In permanent, they are to be made only when the fundamental relations between some parts or lines are disturbed. So company is going to do these particular adjustments. We are not supposed to do. We are not going to open the instrument and change any of the things that is already set. Okay, so these are some permanent adjustments which are done usually during the time of calibration, or if it is broken down, then we do go and open or see permanent adjustments. Temporary adjustments are to be made at every instrument setting and preparatory to taking observations with instrument. So every time you set up the instrument at one particular point, you are supposed to carry out temporary adjustments, that is leveling of the instrument. Now these temporary adjustments are three types or three steps. First is setting up of the level, second is leveling up, and third is elimination of parallax. Now the first one, in setting up of level, again it is divided into two: fixing the instrument on the tripod, leveling by leg adjustment. In leveling up, it can be of two types: either it can be three screw head or it can be a four screw head. Elimination of parallax is, first step is focusing the eyepiece and second one is focusing the object. We will go and study each and every step in detail. So let us start with setting up of the level. The first part is fixing the instrument on the tripod. So here in the picture you can see there is a small knob that is given with which you are going to mount the instrument onto the tripod. Second is leveling by leg adjustment. So this is a basic leveling done by you only using the legs of the tripod. This is same as how we level our tripod for a camera. If you are video shooting or if you are taking a picture, then you see to it that your instrument or your camera is in is leveled by just leveling the three legs or the three screws or three legs of the tripod. Okay, so this is the first basic adjustment that you are supposed to do using the tripod legs. Next leveling up is of the instrument. This is a detailed leveling. This it depends on the type of instrument. If it has three screws, it will be a three screw head, and the second one, it can have four screws, so it can be the leveling is slightly different in that case. So when it has three screws, as you have seen in the picture, if these are the 3 foot screws of the instrument. Okay, the first step is you are supposed to keep the telescope parallel to any 2 foot screws of the instrument. So here in this case, consider this foot screw A and B, and the first position of the instrument will be this telescope is mounted parallel to these 2 foot screws, and you have to move these 2 foot screws either inwards or outwards and see to it that the level tube which is mounted on the telescope is exactly at the center. Once you do this, the second position of the telescope will be perpendicular to the previous 2 foot screws. So you have to move the telescope perpendicular to these 2 foot screws, and now move only the 3rd foot screw to level the tube again. Okay, so this leveling of instrument with 3 screw heads has 2 steps. First, you have to keep the telescope parallel to A and B foot screw, level the tube, then move the leveling tube or the telescope perpendicular to foot screw A and B. By rotating only C, level the tube. You have to repeat this till in both the position the tube is leveled. Okay, we will also do this when we meet for practicals. This is for 3 screw head. Similarly, it is for 4 screw head. So you have to keep the telescope parallel to any 2 foot screws. Move